I heard you ran into that Mary girl.
Yep.
And?
You got me thinking how that all ended. Long time ago now.
What happened?
Well, she didn't love me enough, I guess. Or I wouldn't change.
Huh. Well, she was a fool then, Arthur.
Well, she put a lot of good years in on an outlaw. She definitely was a fool.
In these books, life seems so simple, but in reality, I can't make head nor tail of it.
Mr. Morgan! Mr. Morgan, we have a problem. A real problem. It's Tilly.
What?
She's been taken by them Foreman brothers she used to run with. Come along!
The Foreman brothers? What are they doing here?
Well, I don't know what they've been doing here, but I can tell you what they're going to be doing here. Dying.
What you want?
Kind sir, we're lost and in need of some help.
Well, get out of here!
Oh, I see that kindly face of yours, and I know that for the right inducements.
Now get out of here.
Oh, now you keep saying that. You don't mean nothing by
it. I said...
You said your last word.
Well, what are you waiting for? Get in there and find our girl. I'll take that.
Go find her before they put a bullet in her head.
What's going on out there? Kill that son of a bitch!
Finish those bastards off!
The hell? What the...
It's okay, Miss Tilly. Now, let's get you out of here. Hold up.
I thought there was...
Yeah, it don't matter what you thought. It's okay. All right, let's go.
Oh, come along, miss. Thank you, both of you.
What happened?
It was Anthony Foreman. He thinks he owns me.
I remember. Where is he?
He went out hunting or something. There were five of them, I think.
Well, we killed those fellas there.
There they are.
Come on.
Tilly, grab that gun. Anyone approaches, shoot them.
Oh, don't worry. I'll be just fine. Now catch that bastard. The one in front of the boss. Bring him back alive. I ain't done with him yet.
All right, get after them. You're gonna pay, all of you. Good shot. Oh, hurry. We're going to lose them. Stay right on their tail, Arthur. All right, I think that last one's the boss. Lasso him and we'll take him back to Tilly.
You stay the hell out of this.
Come here.
That's it. Now make sure you tie him up real good.
I'll kill you.
Got you now.
Oh, Mara.
Make these nice and tight.
All right. You bring that bastard back to Tilly so we can all have a nice little chat. I'm gonna head over there now to check she's okay.
With pleasure. This could get bumpy.
Do you have the first idea what you're getting into? I'm Anthony Foreman.
Well, thanks for the introduction, Anthony. Is that Foreman with an A? I want the Undertaker to spell it right.
Funny bastard. Who are you running with?
She didn't tell you?
She didn't tell me nothing. This rope is cutting into me.
Don't feel so good when you're the one tied up, does it?
She killed my goddamn cousin.
Oh, don't worry. You'll be seeing him soon enough.
What are you gonna do with me?
I ain't sure yet. Reckon I'll let Tilly decide what you deserve.
You're wasting your time with that girl. She's a liar. She'll screw you over like she did me. I should have shot the bitch yesterday like I said I would.
You just shut your mouth now, Anthony. I've heard enough.
Son of a bitch.
Bring
bring him here. Dump him on the ground here. I want to get a good look at this monster.
All right, let's go.
So he's still alive then?
Yes.
You see this girl? You leave her alone.
She killed my cousin.
Your goddamn cousin had it coming, Anthony Foreman.
I don't care if she shot your daddy and cooked your mama for breakfast. She's mine. She ain't yours.
You know, a friend of mine, he always says, revenge is a fool's game. Now, you want all your boys dead? She had her reasons.
We was family, Tilly Jackson.
You Foreman boys ain't no kind of family I want.
Kill him, Arthur!
You want that?
I want him to go away and tell the remaining of his cousins and the clowns he rides with to leave me alone!
Now, you think you can do that, Anthony? Or should I slit your throat and just save us all the bother?
I'll leave you alone. History is done.
History is never done. It's your call, Arthur. But I'd slit his throat. Let's get you home.
Now get out of here.
White. Although I don't know why they call him that. Look at him.
Don't you start now.
I'll knock the color clean off you. Come on.
And I'll tell you, you lily livered.
Enough. You two fools look like you've just run off a chain gang.
Yeah, what of it?
What are you doing?
Starving.
They got bounty posters for us all over town.
And we can't go into town to get supplies.
Say, mister, maybe you can do us fools a favor. We ain't bad guys at all. He's okay, even for a darkie.
Shut up, you pasty-faced streak of piss!
Yeah, I had up to here with you.
Enough! Do you a goddamn favor, what you want?
Maybe you can go into town and take down them wanted posters of us.
Okay.
Maybe meet us back at the campfire in the woods and tell us how you did.
Maybe bring us a little bite to eat?
Don't push your luck.
Nice fella.
Yeah, you love nice fellas.
Don't you start up again. Just shut up.
You shut up!
These posters, where are they exactly?
They got them all over town. Check the train station, wherever they'd likely to advertise rewards.
Sir, good morning.
You know, them's bad men.
Sure.
Real unpleasant.
Thank you.
You interested in a little friendly competition? You a shoot?
Okay, then, partner.
Glorious.
Mr. Mason?
Oh, oh, Mr. Morgan.
You want to be careful up here. Land is real treacherous.
Sure.
Real treacherous. I've been here before.
Have you?
Yes. Funny how things turn out. Never quite how you expect, is it?
No, I don't suppose it is.
What you shooting?
Eagles. You know, the images, they really are beautiful. All thanks to you. I'd be some poor creature's bad meal by now, many times over, but for you.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Please, you step away from the cliff edge.
I'm trying to get an eagle there.
Yeah, they're beautiful, but unlike you, they can fly.
Too true. You really must think I'm a buffoon, don't you? You think I'm such a dimwit, I'd just slip off the edge of a cliff.
No, but, well, maybe a little.
Please, sir. I'm dense, but not that dense. This area is quite safe. Quite. Oh, oh!
Damn!
You're right. I am that much of a buffoon. Give me a hand, please. Put me out of my misery.
Come here.
Oh, thank you. You know what? Bugger the eagles, I'm going home. You know, I really did get some amazing pictures, thanks to you. And somehow, I haven't quite broken my neck.
You take care.
And you too, sir. Sorry for all the trouble. Oh.
Hello, can I help you?
Ticket, please.
Right then, just head inside the tent.
Boom! She let out a shriek, then went to chastising.
You should be ashamed of yourself, Eugene Hutton, she said. Instead of giving a girl protection, you go carry on acting foolish and fresh like the Queen's prize jester.
But right then and there, a chilly wind blew through and knocked off Eugene's hat.
I need to get back home. My mama has a terrible temper. She's like to stomp up and down if she finds out we're missing.
She is a fair, stout woman, Eugene noted. But just then, before this couple of miscreants could head home, they heard the sound of heavy wheels groaning and people marching. The cacophony grew closer and closer, and through the fog they could make out the shapes of ghost horses pulling spectral cannons and dead soldiers marching as if their graves could no longer contain them, each wearing a vile red coat.
You will pay for your moral transgressions, the dead soldier howled and cut his head clean off. Miss Bouchard shrieked in horror as Eugene's head landed right in her hands, his eyes still darting about, attempting to discern what horror had transpired. Little Miss Ethel Beauchard ran as fast as she could, stumbling and getting caught on trees as she tore through the forests. Terrified for her life, the dead soldiers marching after, hungry for blood. When she returned home, she told the people of the village that an army of the dead had taken Eugene within the confines of the fog. British soldiers who died protecting tyranny were rising from their graves as if to continue the fight for the demonic English. The townspeople erupted in fright and dismay until one daughter came forth and accused her of witchcraft.
She raised the dead to murder that boy for his pursuit of unwanted advances, he said. So she too must perish.
And that very night, they put her to the stake and burned her dead. Now let that be a lesson to you young ones not to go courting in the woods, in case the English lurk there still.
So long.
Thank you.
time, but I don't mind. Just wanna rock you, girl. I'll have whatever you have. Come on, let's give it a whirl. See, I've been watching you. I like the way you move. So go ahead, girl, just do it. That ass shaking thing you do.
So you grab the girls and you grab a couple more. And they all can meet me in the middle of a floor. So the air is thick, it's smelling right. So you pass to the left and you sail to the right. Don't be so quick to walk away. Dance with me. I wanna rock your body. Please stay. Dance with me. You don't have to admit you walk away. Dance with me. Just let me rock you.
This place feeling brand new, you know.